being filmed by a nosy booker?
No.
No. Okay. The next item is item two. I'm Kate from Metro Rail's going to take this.
Thanks, Bill. First of all, can I just thank you all for attending this meeting at such short notice. The Hoylake Neighbourhood Planning Forum, a decision statement on the Hoylake Neighbourhood Plan, was published on the 14th of September, and that triggered the requirement for a neighbourhood planning referendum. Can you all hear me out the mic? The neighbourhood referendum area is not coterminous with electoral wards or electoral polling districts. So it can be sometimes a bit difficult to determine the polling stations for referendum areas. This is only the second one that we've undertook since the Localism Act Bill was passed in 2011. However, the rules do state that if there are already polling districts within the referendum area, then we should make all attempts to use those polling stations as the polling stations within the referendum area. So, the polling district, the referendum area comprises of polling district NB, part of polling district NC, and a small amount of polling district NA that's within the Hoylake Isles ward. The polling station for NC is Hoylake Chapel, and the polling station has told me that they are available on the 1st of December. Polling station for polling district NA is St John's Church Centre in Forest Road. However, there are only 43 electors within the polling district of NA that are eligible to vote in this referendum. And those 43 electors are more or less situated on the boundary of the NB polling district. So I'll come to that later about what I'm recommending for those electors. But what we're here for today is to designate Hoylake Community Centre as the polling station for this referendum that's situated within the polling district NB. And the reason why is because we have the designated polling station is Hoylake Holy Trinity C of E Crime School. And we've asked them if they were available on the 1st of December. And they rather bluntly suggested no, they weren't. More so because they didn't want to close the school again for polling, which would cause further disruption to the pupils and the parents, having already closed on two occasions this year, one for the elections in May and one for the referendum in June. I was quite in agreement with that decision. And the head teacher was the one that made the suggestion for Hoylake Community Centre to have a look at that, which I did. And I find it, you know, more than suitable for polling purposes. It has adequate disabled access, and there is plenty of parking for anyone that turns up in a car. It is situated along the seafront at Hoylake. So, looking at the map, you can see that it's quite the other end of the other side of the polling district to the school. But again, looking at the map, it's within the main residential area of polling district NB. If you look on the map where the school is, there aren't that many residential properties on that side of the road. Most of the residential properties are on the side where Hoylake Community Centre is. Also, it's a well-known centre within the community. really NA, because there's only 43 electors, and their designated polling station is right the other side of the polling district. I don't think it's fair to them to have to travel all the way over there, 43 of them, have the polling station at St John's Centre hired at a cost of £350, plus the staffing costs it would incur for 43 electors.
Okay, is there any problems? Before I begin, can I just indicate that I've been pointing out that Tom's standing for deputise and for
action.
Jeff.
Thank you, Jim. My understanding is that the ward council's working on us all in quite in favour with this.
Is everyone agreed on that? Is there anything else from